If you're looking to become a better content creator, one of the things you're gonna soon realize is organizing your files, whether you have a Mac or a PC. There is a very strategic way for you to do that, and there are many standards that have been set by the industry that you can actually learn from. So in this video, I'm gonna show you how I organize my files and the commonalities that it has across different platforms. So whether you're using Premiere Pro, Final Cut, any other non-linear editor, there's commonalities that these programs share that'll help you create better content faster and more efficiently. Hey, how's it going, guys? Cesar Santos here, and this channel is all about helping you and inspiring you to create content with whatever means necessary. So if you're interested in learning about technology, gear, or other ways of creating content, make sure you subscribe and hit the bell for notifications. So when I first started on my journey of being a content creator years ago, I started off by using Vegas Pro, an old non-linear editor, which apparently is still available, which I had no idea. However, I didn't do any sort of organization of my files. I didn't optimize the program accordingly. And there's so much that I didn't do that made the program run a lot slower, as well as make the ability for me to search and find files that I needed for a specific project. Organizing your files is where it starts. That way you have the ability to create content fast and efficiently. So let's go ahead and show you exactly how I do that. All right, before we get started, obviously there are a few things you're gonna need to know. I am working off of a Windows PC. However, everything I'm gonna show you will work fine on Mac, or if you're a Linux video editor, it could even work that same way because file structure is pretty much universal. So first off, I'm gonna go ahead and just give you a quick breakdown of my system so that way you guys understand what I'm dealing with and why I work the way I do, and hopefully helping you along the way. Every computer should have at least two hard drives. I highly recommend you have at least two hard drives. Most non-linear editors, from Premiere Pro to DaVinci Resolve, recommend two drives, one for where your programs are running. In my case, a local disk C is where all my programs are at, and another drive where you can house all of your video files and whatnot. However, if the more drives you have, the more efficient your software will run because it's having the ability to grab footage from different drives. In this case, I do keep all of my working videos when I'm working on a video. I do keep them all on the fastest drive, which is this 2 terabyte NVMe drive. It's super fast. And then I keep any other assets for my videos that I use in over time, if it comes to like music, photos, MoGurt files, After Effects files, all those things. I keep them on other faster hard drive disks, which are these. These are creative drives. They're pretty quick for being hard drives. And this is also where I archive all of my footage that I've used on previous videos. That way I can also access it if I need to reference them later. One other drive that pretty much any, again, non-linear editor recommends is having a scratch disk. All programs need to have some sort of access to some space on your computer to write and read different types of files. So whether it's your video previews and all of that, you need a scratch disk. It makes everything a lot faster. If you don't have a scratch disk, it's fine. You just wanna make sure it's being referenced from another faster hard drive on your computer, which I recommend. In this case, if I didn't have this, I would just have it here. Now that you know how my computer's set up and why it is, we're gonna go ahead and get started with the folder structure. Again, this folder structure that I'm gonna show you is something that I came up with over time of working with different clients, as well as reading different documents online about how big production houses use file structure to organize all of their projects and obviously work with multiple and different people all at once. So again, I have my main 2 terabyte hard drive. I have a folder called Workstation. I have other files here. And on my workflow here, I do have it separated by the year of, and it's important to know when, obviously, what year you're working in. And then if you need to reference anything from the previous year, there it is as well. Now I do have a master folder that I simply copy. And this is actually where we're gonna go and look at this first. All right, so first of all, again, this folder structure is super efficient and it's 8 folders. Everywhere online I've looked, some recommend only having 6 to 7, others just have 5. It all really depends on what you're gonna end up being working with. If you're just working with some simple stuff, maybe you just need like 4 or 5 of these folders. But I've come to realize that these are the only amount of folders that you need. However, inside of these folders is other folders to help you organize your files and whatnot. All right, first off, one of the things you'll notice immediately is how I have all the folders numerated. This allows you to quickly access them and they'll always stay in this order. And you'll see why this is important when I open up Premiere Pro in a little bit and show you why I have it numerated this way and obviously keeping things organized. So we'll start off in the first Premiere Pro folder. Obviously I have a master Premiere Pro file that's constantly updated to whatever version I'm using. And as you can see, it's just a little quick, you know, enumerated text file that helps me remember exactly what needs to be what. Second folder is images. This houses all of your images that you use for your project, whether it's JPEGs, PSDs, and whatever the case is. The third folder is for external footage. Obviously, screen record and stock footage are something that I mainly work with, and then I can obviously put other folders inside of there that name where I got the screen records or the stock footage from. VFX. This is probably one of my favorite folders because I have all my transitions, my Unreal Engine backgrounds and whatnot, any other After Effects files or components that I use for the project go in there too as well. Graphics. So motion graphic templates is something that if you do work with Adobe and use MoGraph files or even After Effects files, these templates do get saved on your scratch list, but I import them into here when I'm done. That way I can always reference them for later. The next thing, obviously, folder number 6 is probably one of the most important ones here. It houses all of your video, your audio files, your proxy files. If you do transcode your footage, if you're working with like red footage and you need that transcoded, obviously it's right there. Audio, this is where I house all of the sound effects, music, and I can obviously make other folders for anything else that I have or need. And finally, exports. This is where anything that I render for final output, whether it's going on YouTube or getting sent to a client, goes here. So in the case that if I'm working with a client on YouTube or I'm uploading my own YouTube video, for example, I put it here, or if it's going on Facebook or if it's going on Instagram, Vimeo, Rumble, all of those things, they get there. And obviously we have the master exports that are the final ones, and then social stuff like TikTok, YouTube, Shorts, Reels, etc. And so now I'm gonna show you why this specific organization is important for your non-linear editor. Again, I use Premiere Pro, but if you have anything else, it's gonna work the exact same way. So first of all, we're gonna go ahead and copy this structure. Again, we can actually just copy this whole folder. We're gonna go into my YouTube channel folder, and here you'll see that I actually have all of the months listed here as well. Up from 2022. It's also important to stay organized that way. That way you know where your projects are at and it's easy to figure out. So we're gonna go ahead and paste this, and we're gonna rename this to example project. And then we're gonna go into the Premiere Pro folder. We're gonna rename this. This is gonna actually be episode 28. The show in this case is called Cesar Santos, and the title, it's just a working title. We'll just call it example. And then the date today is the 8th. And then obviously initial, I'm just gonna initial this. This is just, if you are working with like a team or something, then you know who worked on which project and their initials are on it. And then the version of this specific project file is V1. Always start off with V1. All right, so now that we're done with that, we're gonna go ahead and double click on our example project. It's all opened up, and I'm actually going to be working in the effects panels. For those of you guys that are wondering, this is the standard effects panel. So as you can see, I actually have every single folder from that specific file structure already here on the side. The only folder that's not here is obviously the Premiere folder, however, and it's actually my sequence folder. This is where all of my sequences are. This is where I have everything here as well, from string outs to nested files, anything delivered at the end, obviously, for the final sequence. You should just go there when you're done. Everything from the specific folder here, like I said, is all right here. And that's why I was saying that it was important for you to notate that when you're creating these folder structures. And then obviously, because it's gonna translate into your libraries, whether it's on DaVinci Resolve or Final Cut Pro, having these folder structures will help you guys edit faster, create projects faster, because it has for me. To show you guys just how efficient this is, I'm actually gonna open up a project that you've actually already seen by now, and it's my Not In Focus video. All right, so as you can see here, this is actually an example of me using that specific file structure. So again, look, here's all my different edits, my selects and my string outs, and anything obviously nested too as well as there. Images as well too, obviously, and external footage, like I said, screen records. And as you can see here, obviously here is my project, the final outcome of that video that you saw on there. Like I mentioned at the beginning of the video, organizing your files is key to becoming a better content creator. So if your goal is to expand either your network, grow out your business as a freelancer, or as just a content creator on different platforms, you need to stay organized. So following the steps that I showed you guys in the video, as well as making sure that all of your projects are set correctly from the beginning, will make you a better creator. So thank you guys so much for watching. I appreciate all the feedback that I get in the comment section. If you have anything to say about this specific video or any other video, please leave a comment down below. Thank you guys again so much for watching, and as always, have a great day.